You can see Kelly has tried to pull out more water holes, gardening water holes from the container. The connection is very simple, very straightforward, and anyone can do it. We just use that connector, and we get it from the dollar shop, which is cost $2.50 per pack. And easy, and no maintenance at all, and cheap.
It is what it is.
Exactly. So that is it. You can see us parking our water tank on our main road. So you can see what we talk about is a really flexible, very easy to use the water tank trailer for the watering, because basically we can park our water tank anywhere we like, and but we are not parking on the main road. But however, we are parking on the side, and yeah, it's a really good asset, and also it's really reasonable price as well, and also multifunction. Okay, that's it.
Tree. This will be 8 or 9. That's 1, 2, 3. So 19 8-4-9s and 1, 2, 4, 6. Over there, and where are we gonna plant them now? 6 will go here. This hole's been sitting here for a few months. I've got my knife, yep. So, yeah, a bit eroded away over the time. Had a bit of rain since May this year, so need to rough it up a bit. The sea soil in the water, so it should be clear water, but it's not, it's groundwater. That's from the fertilizer. Might take a little while to come through, just gonna get all the air out of the hose. Generous to this. Okay. Okay, and we will put it that way.
Okay.
Straighten it up.
We found it so straight up is very important from last lot.
Well, the winter winds are over, the westerly winds, so we don't have to worry about it for a year. But a few of our trees we planted in May got completely bowled over by the wind. And so we took a bit of effort to straighten them out. They hadn't had their roots. They hadn't sort of gotten themselves stabilised in the soil with their root system, and strong winds came and knocked about 3 or 4 of them over. But they're still alive, which is great. Okay, we'll give another water. So cheery little trees left. A little 849. We'll dam it up so that the water doesn't wash away. There it goes. I think the water will sort of help the tree get over the shock of transplanting and having its roots exposed to the sunlight, and give it the best chance of survival. This is basically what we've been doing so far, and it seems to work, so we're going to keep on doing it. Okay, grab the knife. Get back in.
Carol, gotta go down here. the brake off, the handbrake off the machine and
roll it down the hill.
It's all right.
Bring the little speaker, did we? Roll it down again after this.
How about we drive back and grab the speaker? Did that?
Yeah.
We'll go down here and we'll fire up the mini loader. The load up the wood chip onto the back of the club car. loading wood chip onto the back of our pub car, which is over there. Carry-all side by, and the trailer, a little trailer behind it. And we're loading up wood chip to mulch our trees.
We'll see how it goes.
about to move it.
Right.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, driving out, you see our trees, to the right there. This is a much easier way of mulching than we've done before because, first of all, there's no noise, the engine is off on the machine, so it's nice and peaceful, no stress. Second of all, our capacity of mulch every trip has gone up dramatically because the little club car has got a good tray on the back. Down here.